Sometimes a single internet connection isn't enough. So I'm going to show you how to load balance two internet connections using a Synology RT2600ac router. It's TechWizTime. Hope everyone's having a great week. My name is Jonathan and this is TechWizTime, where I create technology tutorials and review videos. If you haven't subscribed, then make sure you do and hit that bell icon too. Most people are happy with their current internet connection, but for those that have the need for dual connections, load balancing can offer a faster experience. And that's where the Synology RT2600ac router comes in. This video will show you how to set up load balancing for two WAN connections. Full disclosure, Synology sent out the RT2600ac router so I could create this load balancing tutorial. No money exchanged hands. With that all said, let's get started. Synology have an awesome interface called the Synology Router Manager, or SRM. It's similar to their DSM interface. So if you are a Synology NAS user, then you'll feel right at home. A few things you will need before we get started. First and foremost, you will need two internet connections. In this tutorial, I'll be using two Australian NBN fiber to the node connections. The modems are already set up, so the second thing you will need is two Ethernet cables. We will run one cable from each modem into the Synology RT2600ac router. This particular router comes with dual WAN ports, so it is required for load balancing. So one Ethernet cable goes into the blue WAN 1 port, and the other goes into the yellow WAN 2 port shown here. Now that we have the hardware set up, let's jump over to the computer and set up the software side of load balancing. Log into your Synology Router Manager and click on the main menu in the top left corner. Select the Network Center icon. Now we need to choose Internet from the left-hand side. Now before we go any further, if your screen doesn't have Smart WAN along the top, this could be due to your operation mode being set to wireless AP instead of the required wireless router. This can cause issues if you switch from wireless AP to wireless router, so do this at your own risk. Now that disclaimer is out of the way, back to the tutorial. So in the Internet section of the Network Center, we need to enable secondary interface. This will change the LAN 1 port to a WAN port. Leave the other settings as default for the time being and click on the blue apply button. After a short wait, we can then click on the Smart WAN tab up the top. This is where we have the option to change how the two WAN interfaces will behave. Initially, the WAN 2 port is set up to be used as a failover internet connection. So if the primary internet connection drops out, then the secondary internet connection will automatically pick up the traffic and continue providing internet access. Clicking the two arrows will change which WAN port is active and which is the backup or failover. Right now though, we want to click on the drop-down menu and select load balancing plus failover. Next, we can choose the balance between the two connections. As an example, if WAN 1 internet connection is slower than WAN 2, you may want to give WAN 2 a greater percentage of the load. As an alternative, you can also set up a 3G or 4G USB dongle in place of either WAN 1 or WAN 2. Simply click on the drop-down arrow beside the interface you want to change and select the 3G and 4G option from the drop-down menu. How awesome is that? Before we hit apply though, we can change some of the advanced settings. Clicking on Interface Property, we can change the importance of several different network interfaces. By clicking on the interface and then clicking on the Up or Down button, you can move or change the priority of that network interface. This is handy if you want your faster network interface to take priority over a slower one. Once done here, just click the blue OK button. Next, we have the Policy Route. Here we can make sure certain IP addresses are used by a single WAN interface rather than balancing them across both. This is handy when it comes to different servers or banking websites requiring a fixed IP address. To configure this, simply click on the Create button and input your PC's IP address under Source IP and the server or website's IP address under Destination IP. Under the Interface drop-down box, select which WAN connection you want to use and then click the blue Create button. And lastly, we have the Interface Check section. This is where we can set up the failover tolerances and retries. Make sure there is a tick in the Enable Interface checkbox. The default values here are fine for most people, but you can change the intervals and retries here to suit your needs. You can also add a site for checking that the interface is still active. Input the URL and click the Add button. I would recommend having several sites here in case one is having issues. Once you're done, click the blue OK button. Now, if everything is all set up, click on the blue Apply button and your internet connections will now be load balanced. How awesome is that? There's so much more you can do with the Synology router, so if you've got any suggestions for future Synology videos, then leave me a comment down below and let me know. Consider subscribing to TechWizTime to see more Synology and technology videos. Already a subscriber? Then click on the bell icon to get instant notifications of my new videos. Like and share this video if you enjoyed it, and as always, imagine, learn, create.